After the devastating Lahaina fire, you might be wondering if there is anything left to do on West Maui. Well, West Maui is more than just Lahaina. And while you can no longer go to Lahaina, there is a lot to do in Kaanapali up to Kapalua. So we are here to show you that today.
So we're going to show you all the great things to do in this area of West Maui. Don't worry, got you covered. We're going to do this kind of like an itinerary day. We're going to start off in the morning, like we're on Napili Beach right now at sunrise, and take you through to the sunset, beautiful sunset cruise. Pick and choose what you want to do. There's so much to do. Hi, I'm Jordan.
And I'm Erica.
And this is the Hawaii Vacation Guide. That's how you start your Maui vacation. Let me give you an overview of West Maui, especially geography, what we're talking about. So West Maui is obviously West Maui. It's this other, about 30% of Maui is West Maui in the West Maui Mountains. You can drive around the side of it, coming up the Honoapiolani Highway, down from the south side of it, comes on up. You'll go right past Lahaina on the Lahaina Bypass, and then up to the resorts in Kaanapali. A lot of these resorts were built in the 60s and 70s, but I think they've kept them well-maintained. You got North Kaanapali, then you got Honokowai, then you got Buff Kaanapali. You have a lot of nice little shopping centers heading up to Kahana and then Napili and then all the way up to Kapalua. Kapalua is famous for the Montage and the Ritz resorts. So weather up here, the farther you get up north in West Maui, the more dicey the weather gets, right? Now, Kaanapali is on the leeward side of the island, so the weather's gorgeous. You get lots of amazing sunny days. But as you go a little farther north, up to like Napili and Kapalua, you get like that cloud behind me right there. It comes off top of the mountains, and you can get some sudden downpours, a little bit of rain, stuff like that. It passes over fast. It makes it really nice. Plus, you can get some really nice rainbows too. But it's a little wetter up here. We like it up here because it's wetter and so it's greener. So jet lag probably got you this morning, right? Got us. We were up about 4 a.m. this morning with our toddler. Head right out. You can go swimming on Kaanapali Beach to start off your day, or here at Napili Bay. We love breakfast, and a lot of places open up early. You got the famous Gazebo restaurant. That is a great local place to go. The lines do get big, so we recommend getting there right when they open at 7:30. But if not, the line moves fast. They usually serve coffee there too. Give out umbrellas if it rains, it's great. But for us, we're gonna have the Sea House, which is at the Napili Kai Resort, because we knew there's gonna be no line, and they opened a little earlier too. We're out up at 4 a.m. So it is wonderful here. You can walk in Napili Bay, why it's so quiet. Just check out these resorts. I like these resorts in Napili because they're all like really small. They're only 2 stories high, nothing taller than a coconut tree. A lot of them are very vintage, older vibe to them. And it makes it a lot of fun to stay up here. You find some good value hotels here, like Napili Surf and Napili Shores. And this one is Napili Kai. They're all great. They're really cool to stay at.
All right, while the Sea House is a great place for breakfast, they are really known for their happy hour and for their slat key performances. And they've been included on our Best Places to Eat in Maui on the Beach article that we have on our website. Their happy hour is so great because the sunset is absolutely beautiful.
Finally, let's talk beaches. Some of the best beaches in Maui are in West Maui, in our opinion, and especially Northwest Maui. So right now I'm in Kapalua Beach. This beach is gorgeous. Just a golden crescent-shaped bay. It has a nice place for snorkeling on it. Great place to see sea turtles. Remember to stay 10 feet away from sea turtles when swimming with them. And this is a nice place to spend the day. This and Napili Bay. The nice thing about having breakfast at Napili Bay, like at the gazebo or at the Sea House or like a coffee shop, is then you can just keep your parking spot and hit the beaches, because a lot of the parking here fills up even by like 8:30, 9 o'clock because they're so popular. Check out our Maui Wayfinder itinerary link down below for tips on parking. Kind of take the stress out of coming up here. But you can spend the whole day here just relaxing at the beach. There's bathrooms here at Kapalua. Also, a little farther north, you have DT Fleming Beach and Honolulu Beach. DT Fleming Beach is good for bodyboarding and surfing. It does have a rough shore break, so be careful out there. And then Honolulu Bay is wonderful for snorkeling. It is a marine sanctuary, marine preserve, so a great place for snorkeling. Just remember, don't step on the reef, wear mineral-based sunscreen, and stay away from sea turtles and other marine life. Keep everyone safe out there. Have a good day here. For us, we're not hitting the beach here. We're going back to Kaanapali Beach and pick up some local snorkel equipment first. Up here too, you also have some really nice hiking trails. You have the Kapalua Coastal Hiking Trail. Also, you can hike down to Dragon's Teeth and the Labyrinth over in front of the Ritz. And you have Mahana Ridge, which is more moderate advanced hike that takes you to the top of the mountain. right now I'm by the Ritz, the resort area of Kapalua, and right here at Kapalua Zipline. It's right by the Ritz. Erica did this last year. Hedge is a great time out on. It's a dual line zip course, takes you all over.
I just remembered, I'm scared of heights.
Also in this area, it's famous for golfing. You got the Plantation Golf Course, which the PGA always plays at every year. So it's a nice area here. You got ABC store full of like stuff like Dole Whip, and you got some other nice restaurants like Italian restaurant, The Poorhouse. So a lot of nice restaurants around here. They do sell out fast, so make reservations early. Right in their heart, Kaanapali, off the highway, is the Fairway Shops, and here is the Snorkel Store. It's one of our favorite snorkel stores on all the island. It's locally owned and operated. They did a great job during the Lahaina fire. They provided free shave ice on Friday, so we had to pick up some shave ice while we were here. But we came for snorkel gear, because we're gonna go snorkel at Black Rock on Kaanapali Beach, and we also got our friendship bracelets. So we're ready to go. Here at the Snorkel Store, it's not just snorkel rentals, they also have a ton of beach rental equipment, like coolers and chairs, and just a bunch of stuff. Come here for your mineral-based sunscreen. Everything you need for the beach is right here. It's really convenient. It's a no-brainer. It's better than bringing your own stuff. While we're on the way for some poke, make sure to check out our Maui Wayfinder itinerary. They have perfectly planned out itinerary days to take you across Maui with even more things to do. Also, check out our Maui travel update article down below. We keep it updated with all the latest news on visiting Maui. Well, I enjoy my poke that I just picked up. I forgot my chopsticks. Let's talk some food around West Maui. Up in Napili, I think is your best place for lunch, especially a lot of great local lunch places. I'm in Napili Plaza right now. Yes, it's a strip mall, but there's a lot of great restaurants here, like Joey's Kitchen, got Maui Tacos, and if you're vegan, they have A'a Roots, which is a wonderful place for like smoothies and acai bowls and tons of great like vegan food. It does a really good job. Also, right behind me is Fond. Fond is a local chef. He's kind of like a celebrity chef. He's Chef Vasquez, and it's like a really cool mix of Hawaiian fusion, Pacific Asian fusion. It's just a great restaurant for lunch. You should really check it out. Lunch or dinner time, it's kind of like a nice little fine dining for lunch, but not too expensive either. All these places are really well priced. So we saved ourselves for snorkeling to one of our favorite spots is Black Rock. It's right at the end of Kaanapali Beach, at least the end, that's right in front of the Sheraton, right past the Westin and the Kaanapali Beach Resort. Black Rock is a wonderful place to go out. You usually can see sea turtles here. The front side's easy. Easy, I say, is like a moderate, easy place to go snorkeling because the currents aren't so strong. But you gotta watch out. There is good snorkeling around the area where they're jumping off the rocks, but you just have to watch for high currents out there, strong currents and waves. Always check the weather before you head out. Check the lifeguard flags.
All right, and on West Maui, there are still plenty of tours that you can do. So straight here from Kaanapali Beach, you have beach loading tours that include sunset tours, dinner cruise tours, and snorkeling tours. So you have different options like Sea Maui, Trilogy, and Terralani that leave from here. You can also do tours like the Road to Hana or Haleakala Sunrise because the tour companies will pick you up from your accommodations here. So we love Valley Isle Excursions and also Ho'aloha Jeeps if you want like a private Jeep tour. Click the link in the description below for our discount codes.
And of course, whale watching, right? You don't have to go out on a tour here to do whales. From Kaanapali Beach, you can see the whales right offshore from December through about early April, but you can go out on a tour. A lot of the ones that are in Lahaina Harbor go out from Alaia Harbor now. So once again, click down below for our favorite whale tours.
Let's talk shopping. There's a lot of great shopping up and down West Maui. First off, Whalers Village, located in the heart of Kaanapali. There you can find local shops like Kai Aloha and also some big brand name shops. Also, really good for some food, gelato, everything you need is right there. Also, head a little north to Napili Farmers Market. That goes on Wednesday and Saturday mornings. Also, you can find a lot of great local sellers at your hotel. Great way to support local is hit up a lot of the shopping complexes around West Maui.
Another great thing to do in West Maui is what we're doing right now, is we're out on a sunset sail. It's beach loading from Kaanapali, but also you can do snorkel tours from Kaanapali Beach. There's a lot of boats that come out here. Sea Maui, Trilogy, Genesis, Terralani, they all come out. We have an affiliate link down below for the one that we partner up with, which is Sea Maui. We're out on their sunset premiere buffet dinner cruise right now. We're having a lot of fun. The drinks are flowing. The food is really good. They got crying tiger chicken breast, whatever that is, but it's really good. Everyone's just having a blast. But the best is it just leaves right in front of Whalers Village, right on the beach. You just walk right on. It's really easy to get on, walk up the stairs. It's just a great experience to get out in the water. And with Lahaina Harbor closed right now, this is a very convenient option for you to come on out and support the local economy. Everyone on the boat works, and the local food, the drinks, it's all local.
If you decide not to do a sunset dinner cruise, make sure to hit up the Ka'anapali food trucks. We'd love to take our family here. You can get Thai, Vietnamese, Mexican food. You can get a lot of great things there right out in front of the Times Supermarket. Also, like we said, the Sea House Restaurant's great for sunset. Monkey Pod Kitchen in Whalers Village is a great place to grab some food with some live music and grab that Lilikoi for Mai Tai. You won't go hungry in West Maui.
As we mentioned before, for more things to do in West Maui, all of Maui, and all the Hawaiian Islands, make sure you click the link in the description below for our Wayfinder itineraries. Thanks so much for watching.